So now that we have an understanding of the ducts associated with the male reproductive system, let's talk about the male urethra. So we know that those fluids are actually going to drain into this male urethra, and it's going to be the passageway for not only urine, which is going to be homologous with what you have in terms of the female urethra. The female urethra will only be the passageway for urine, but the male urethra will be the passageway for urine as well as semen. So, let's talk about the three main portions of the male urethra. And I really do want to note that oftentimes there is a fourth area that's discussed associated with this most distal portion of the bladder. We're going to focus on the three larger areas, so we'll start with the prostatic urethra. So you can see in terms of this image right here, your prostate, which is going to be just inferior to the bladder, this opening right here, this is what's referred to as the prostatic urethra. It's about 2 to 3 centimeters long, depending on variation, passing through the bulk of the prostate. This will lead into the intermediate, or this middle portion of the urethra. And this is going to be the smallest portion, or the shortest portion. It's only about 1 centimeter. Sometimes you hear this referred to as the membranous urethra. And that's because it's going to be kind of embedded within these deep muscles of the perineum or the perineum. So this is definitely going to be the shortest of the portions of the urethra. So that membranous urethra is going to lead into the most distal as well as the longest portion of the male urethra, and that's going to be the spongy or the penile urethra. And so this is going to traverse the entirety of the penis. One of the reasons why this is named the spongy urethra is because it's actually traversing the corpus spongiosum, which is that unpaired erectile tissue of the penis. This is going to lead to the exit point or end in the external urethral orifice. And through here, you will have not only the exit of urine, but also as well semen. So, now that we have an understanding of how this will actually exit the body, let's talk about some of the components and what's actually producing the components of semen.